कार्टून टीवी।
वैष्णो देवी आदिशक्ति जगदम्बा, द ग्लोरी ऑफ गॉडेस वैष्णो देवी इज इनकम्पेरेबल। If mythology is to be believed, then the superpower Vaishno Devi was so pleased with the worship of her devotee Pandit Sridhar that she came down to help him. And in this way, goddess Vaishno Devi made the whole world aware of her glory. And since then, till today, people seek the blessings of the mother by worshipping Adi Shakti in the holy shrine of Vaishno Devi in Jammu and Kashmir. According to Hindu belief, Vaishno Devi temple is one of the holiest Hindu temples dedicated to Shakti. As per the devotees say, Pandit Sridhar, the supreme devotee of Mother Vaishnavi, lived at some distance from Katra in Jammu and Kashmir. He wasn't very happy because of being childless. One day, he invited unmarried girls for Navratri worship.
Today, we have organized Navratri Puja. I wish to worship you, for which I am humbly inviting you.
I accept your invitation. Mother Vaishno, disguised as a girl, and went and sat among them. After the worship, all the girls left, but Mother Vaishno Devi stayed there and said to Sridhar, "You may invite everyone for a religious feast." Sridhar agreed to that divine girl and sent the message of a religious feast in surrounding villages as well. But he was worried that he himself eats by begging for the food. So how will he manage to arrange the food for so many people? He was returning to his home while thinking this, just when he met Goraknath and Saint Bhairavnath. Sridhar reached out to invite them.
I humbly invite you to a religious feast in my house. If you visit us, we will be blessed.
You a wretch, down and out, poor beggar, will get a religious feast done. Himself who eats the leftover, he will feed us a meal. The food that is not even in all three worlds, I eat that much. And you have come to invite us. The feast falls short wherever I go.
Teacher-student duo started laughing at Sridhar. They ridiculed and he kept listening to all this silently and was very sorry. Still, Sridhar said very politely,
"Still you have to come and increase the glory of the holy feast. I will not let you return hungry."
After getting the invitation for food, all the villagers were surprised. That which girl is she who wants to feed food to so many people? After this, many villagers came to Sridhar's house and gathered for food. Then, Mother Vaishno Devi, in the form of a girl, started serving food to everyone from a unique vessel. While serving food, the girl went to Bhairavnath.
"Girl, you are serving everyone the food of their choice. I also need food of my choice to eat. I will eat meat instead of kheer puri and drink alcohol."
"This is a Brahman's holy feast. And anyway, non-vegetarian food is never served in a religious feast. Eradicating hunger by killing an innocent creature is a sin." But Bhairavnath did not agree and deliberately stayed stuck to his point. Bhairavnath became suspicious of the girl, and when he wanted to capture the girl, the goddess knew of his treachery and flew towards Trikuta Mountain with the speed of light. It is said that Hanuman, the son of Pavan, was also there to protect mother on the mountain, and amid this, Hanuman felt very thirsty. He started searching for water, but he could not find water anywhere.
What are you looking for, Pavan Putra?
I am very thirsty, mother.
On hearing this, the goddess took out a bow and shot an arrow on the mountain, and a stream of water came flowing from the mountain, by which Hanuman quenched his thirst.
Hail down to the goddess!
And today, this sacred water stream is known as Banganga. It is believed that by drinking it or bathing in the holy water, all the tiredness and suffering of the devotees come to an end. During this period, the goddess entered a cave and meditated for 9 months. On the other hand, Bhairavnath was ravaged by the disappearance of Mother Vaishno Devi. And then he indulged in the austerities and started looking for her with his elusive powers. Just when he came to know about the goddess hiding in the cave. And then Bhairavnath reached the cave with the speed of wind, where he encountered a monk.
Whom you are considering just a mighty girl, she is none other than Supreme Goddess Jagdamba. So give up the pursuit of defeating that superpower.
Bhairavnath did not listen to the monk. And being stubborn, he rampantly started walking towards the cave. The monk tried his best to stop him, but he used his force to get inside the cave. But then Hanuman appeared there to protect the mother. He fought with Bhairavnath, but Bhairavnath still did not give up and took a huge form with his elusive powers.
Alak Niranjan! Alak Niranjan!
Hanuman, after seeing the formidable appearance of Bhairavnath, he too became enormous.
Jai Shri Ram! Jai Shri Ram!
And once again, a fierce war between the two got amplified. Hanuman hit the mace hard on Bhairavnath.
Your end has come, Bhairavnath. Now look out. Look out for who saves you from the attack of my mace.
You have no idea of my powers, you brute. Take this!
But Bhairavnath was no less, and he fought Hanuman vigorously with his dagger. In the meantime, when mighty Hanuman started to fell weak, then Mother Vaishnavi came out of the cave.
Wait, Pavan Putra. He is not to be slaughtered by you, but by my hands.
Hanuman goes away after bowing the goddess. When Bhairavnath starts laughing loudly, Mother Vaishno warns Bhairavnath and asks him to return, but he did not agree.
Listen to me. I'm still warning you to go away from here.
Bhairavnath did not agree and started laughing loudly when furious Mother Vaishno attacked Bhairavnath with her trident. Seeing the trident coming towards him, Bhairavnath starts running from there. But the trident chases him and beheads his head from the torso. The head of Bhairavnath falls far into Bhairav Valley of the Trikuta Mountain. And in this way, Mother Vaishnavi destroys Bhairavnath. It is said that after his slaughter, Bhairavnath realized his mistake and begged for forgiveness from the Mother Goddess.
Mother, 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 please come in front of me.
Bhairav.
Oh, Mother Adi Shakti Jagdamba, forgive me, Mother. I am blessed to see you. I have no grudge of time, but I wanted to die with your hands. Now I will certainly attain salvation. O Mother Vaishno Devi, I was unfamiliar with the avatar of yours. If you will not forgive me, Mother, then this world will call me a sinner. They will invariably remember me as miscreant. Please forgive me, Mother.
What do you want, Bhairavnath?
Oh, Mother, Mother of the world, please do some measures so that people do not remember me as a sinner in future. Please.
Bhairavnath, you have called me Mother in your end time, worshipped me, and atoned for your sins. Go, I forgive you and grant you a boon that from today onwards, you will also be worshipped. My devotees will visit you and worship you. After they have visited me and get their wishes fulfilled, without your visit, my worship will be considered incomplete. Walking on your torso, devotees will enter my cave, and then their journey will be successful.
According to the same belief, even today, the devotees go to see Bhairavnath after climbing about 3.25 kilometers after seeing Goddess Vaishno Devi.
Jai Mata Di!
Say with love, Jai Mata Di. Say out loud, Jai Mata Di.
If you enjoyed this video, do like, share and comment. And to be the first person to watch our videos, make sure to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for timely notifications.